The pandemic is making it difficult for many businesses to stay afloat. This week, one of the well-known hotels in Makati announced it is forced to let go of its employees as it temporarily ceases operations. The hospitality industry is one of the hardest hit sectors, with governments around the world imposing travel restrictions. Now joining us in Top Story is Jose Marie del Rosario. He's the director of the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. He's also the CEO of PHINMA Microtel Hotels for a discussion on the state of the country's hospitality industry. Good afternoon, Mr. Del Rosario. Great to have you with us on the show.
Thank you for inviting us at the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. Stanley, thank you very much.
All right. Hotels and resorts have taken a beating, if you will, along with the entire tourism industry, which almost came to a halt as a result of the lockdowns. Now, there were bright spots, though, as many hotels have been serving as quarantine facilities as well as staycation facilities. Now, how has it been after almost a year of that setup for you?
It's been short of disastrous, as what has happened to Shangri-La Makati. They have had to shut down, really, because the revenues were just not coming in. With the pronouncements of government to limit the number of foreigners coming in, international arrivals, towards the end of the year, there was some bright spot as it was sort of easing out. But as the year ended, there was this new list of balikbayans or Filipinos or even those who had visas to come in. So that's been very, very difficult for us.
All right. Before the new variant of COVID-19 came about, the timelines as to the COVID recovery was quite clear for the industry. Well, a vaccine would come and things will slowly return to normal in 2021. That doesn't seem to be the case now with the new variants complicating things. Where do we go from here?
It's really been very difficult for us to, before, you know, when there were disasters like earthquakes, Taal volcano, or flooding, we were able to predict something like a timeline of maybe 3 months, then we can look at recovering.
Yeah.
But in this case, really, it's been one disaster after another, in the sense that there is no way to predict, because this is a global phenomena. And the ones that are bringing us the warm bodies, which is the airlines, are also themselves suffering. And even the land travel, there seems to be no confidence for Filipinos to travel locally. The farthest that I've seen that they've traveled is really up to Tagaytay only. But as the previous story had mentioned, in Baguio, there's almost nobody coming in. Same with Thing Boracay.
All right, Mr. Del Rosario, we learned about closures, temporary or otherwise, of no less than major hotel chains, Shangri-La in Makati and, of course, Marco Polo in Davao, which happened last year, partly due to mounting losses from low occupancy. Now, if you expect this trend to continue, what help do you need from the government to keep the industry afloat?
We understand the predicament that they're in. But there is only one thing that we can ask, and it's not even a monetary help. Mm-hmm. It is just to have one message between the national government and the LGUs. For example, let's say the LGU of Boracay and Baguio have different formulas on how they're going to allow people to come in. Same thing as here in Metro Manila. Even within the NCR alone, there are different formulas on what is allowed and not allowed. So it's been very confusing for us in the industry. Very difficult.
Isn't it partly because...
That's the only thing, really.
Right. Isn't it partly because each of these areas have different COVID situations? Some are more relaxed and some need to be stricter.
Very true. Very true. But I think there is some commonality that can be achieved. Just between what kind of testing that will be allowed. Will it allow, some are insisting on PCR, and then some are allowing antigen, and then there's this new saliva. If we can just all agree on antigen, that would already be a big step, because it's affordable and the turnaround time for results is quite quick.
Fast. Right.
Yes.
Lastly, what are your ideas to sustain tourism during the pandemic? I mean, is there really a way to somehow keep tourism establishments open and survive until things return to normal? And what can we do for the people working under this industry?
I am sorry to say it, really, a lot of us owners have really dug into our pockets already into keeping the hotel operation as sustainable as possible. We try to keep jobs as much as possible. We try to rotate their schedules. But like in the case of Makati Shangri-La, and even us in the different categories, whether it's a business hotel or even Airbnb, it's been very, very difficult. As I said earlier, just to have one message between the Department of Tourism, the LGUs, and now the Board of Quarantine is also being part of the picture. So please, guys, just have one formula on what we're going to do.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, Mr. Jose Marie Del Rosario, Director of the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, Stanley.